The UK has a rich history of mining. In fact, tin and copper have been mined since the Bronze Age over 5,000 years ago. But no industry exploded quite like the coal mining industry in the Black Country during the Industrial Revolution. It completely changed the landscape. Once a relatively green and rural place, the Black Country quickly earned a reputation. Many described the land as being turned inside out by the mining activity. It was coal mining which was at the heart of the industrialisation of the Black Country. You see, during the Industrial Revolution, the manufacturing of goods began to be transferred to factories powered by steam. Trains were increasingly being used to support the canal network that delivered goods up and down the country, and they required steam. People even began using coal to heat their homes and cook their food. The people of Britain wanted coal, and lots of it. The Black Country, with one of the thickest seams of coal anywhere in Britain, was more than happy to oblige. The coal that lay just beneath the surface was known as Staffordshire Thick, and its seams could reach up to 10 metres deep. But what kind of impact did this new industry have on the people who lived and worked here? The towns of the Black Country began to expand rapidly as families from within and outside the region flocked to work in the mines. As miners worked around the clock to keep up with demand, the landscape became covered with an amazing array of rough and ready mines, which often meant life-threatening working conditions for the miners and created large areas of land with sinkholes and subsidence. In the early days, coal mining was often a small operation done mostly above ground, but as demand for coal increased, workers dug deeper and deeper, eventually digging massive underground pits to mine the coal. In the Black Country, girls and women known as pit bong wenches would sort the coal into different grades and load the coal to be distributed. Coal miners were often paid by the amount and quality of coal they produced, and they could be fined if there was too much slack or smaller pieces of coal. Lots of mine managers set unreasonable standards and often cheated the miners, reeling them in with a relatively high basic wage but reducing their take-home pay through a series of fines. Many miners were also expected to buy their own candles or equipment. Some were even paid in tokens which could only be spent in shops created by the mine owner, allowing the owner to recoup the wages in profits for overpriced foods or goods. The Black Country was the most dangerous place to be a miner in the 19th century, particularly because of the precarious pillar and stall system used. The death rate was an unbelievable 7.3 per 1,000 miners in the 1850s compared to 4.5 for the rest of England. The further underground the workers went, the darker, hotter and more hazardous the working conditions became. Single shaft mines would often flood, collapse or fill with dangerous gases that could cause devastating explosions from a small spark of a miner's axe. Many men and children were drowned, crushed, buried and even burned alive. Mining in the 19th century was backbreaking work. Even if you did manage to survive the many dangers, you could expect a significantly reduced life expectancy if you worked in the mines for extended periods. But this type of work was particularly brutal for one group, children. In 1842, around 40% of those working in coal mines in Staffordshire were children, often from the very poorest families in society. They could be as young as 4 years old. The use of apprentices was common in the Black Country. In a report written in 1842 on the treatment of children working in coal mines, it was noted that there were scarcely any young boys left in the workhouses of Walsall, Wolverhampton, Dudley and Stourbridge. These apprentices were often orphans and were completely at the whim of their butty or mine manager, and their cruel treatment was well known. Many children endured terrible physical abuse and were treated as little more than slaves, often being sent where miner fathers would not dare send their own sons. Apprentice or not, many children faced awful consequences if they did not work quick enough. Remember, more coal equals more money, and older miners could be particularly cruel if they felt they weren't making enough on account of a child not pulling his or her weight. By far one of the worst jobs for children was to work as a trapper. Trappers operated the air doors, providing ventilation for the miners and stopping the build-up of dangerous gases. These young children sat by the door in the dark. They were cold and frightened, with no one to talk to and nothing to do for long periods of the day, often up to 12 hours, 6 days a week. But their job was essential. If it wasn't done properly, an explosion could put the lives of everyone in the mine at risk. Let's find out what happens when the gases in a mine aren't managed properly. On the morning of the 17th of November 1846, there was an explosion at the Rounds Green Colliery, located on the slopes of Rowley Hills in Aldbury. The colliery was mainly lit using candles, but in this particular pit there was a well-known problem with gases. And that meant that lighting a candle without the proper safety checks was incredibly dangerous. A small flame sparked an explosion that ripped through the mine, tragically killing 14 men, 5 children and seriously wounding 5 others. It was one of the worst mining disasters on record for the region, and it was reported up and down the country. An inquiry was held, and it was discovered that gas checks were being performed while men were already in the mine. Government reform was slow to take place. Miners often protested these changes and claimed that new safety regulations would reduce their wages. However, it was only by 1860 that children under 12 were banned from working underground. As the century wore on, various other safety regulations were introduced, and by the end of the 19th century, the industry had gone from being largely unregulated to having miners represented in Parliament through the surging Labour Party. Working as a coal miner in the Black Country was tough, but there was often little choice for families living in the poorer areas of the region. Parents were often faced with the dilemma of putting their whole family to work underground, including the children, or going hungry. If you'd like to learn more, why not visit our website? We have short, interactive lessons and plenty of activities that can be done from home.